And this one is telling that two blocks 1 and 2 connected by a massless string slide down an inclined plane of inclination 37 degree with the horizontal. The masses of the blocks are 4 kg and 2 kg respectively. Frictional coefficients of the blocks with the incline are 0.75 and 0.25 respectively. Since the blocks are in sliding motion, you understand these are frictional coefficient of kinetic friction. Assuming the string to be taut, calculate common acceleration of the blocks and in part B, tension in the string. A typical example of constraint motion. Let us understand the problem in detail as before. Here is the inclined plane, and they have said inclination of this plane with the horizontal, this angle, I'm taking it to be theta symbolically, and they have told this angle is 37 degrees. The significance of this value, I have told you earlier, cos 37 degrees is roughly about 0.8, and sine 37 degrees is roughly about 0.6, easy for calculation. There are two blocks connected by a massless taut string. They are sliding down the incline as shown here, the direction of motion. And let me call the blocks by the numbers 1 and 2. We have been given that mass of block 1, that is M1 I am taking, this is 4 kg. While the mass of block 2, this is M2. This is given to be 2 kg. And there is friction between the inclined plane and these blocks. And since both the blocks are in sliding motion, this is coefficient of kinetic friction. Between the block 1 and the inclined plane, the coefficient of kinetic friction, let it be called mu1. This is mu1 is 0.75. And similarly, between block 2 and the inclined plane, frictional coefficient mu2, that is known to be 0.25. These are the data provided in the problem. We can further take, if required, free fall acceleration g is equal to 9.8 meter per second square. Now, this is a case of constrained motion, and as they have mentioned, the string is massless. Therefore, the tension force exerted by the string on both the blocks must have the same magnitude. And since the string is taut, what is the meaning of that? A string taut means, let me show it here briefly, these blocks are held by a string in tension. If the string was like this, a slack, in such case I cannot assume that acceleration of the blocks will be the same. But while the string is taut, in such case, in case of constrained motion, both the blocks must possess the same acceleration down the incline. It would not be the case if the string was slack like in this figure. So that's the significance of string being taut. So I shall choose a coordinate system convenient for me, that is direction down the incline taken to be my plus x direction, and direction perpendicular to the incline that will be taken to be my plus y direction. The motions take place in a vertical plane. So as before, as I have done in the previous problem to solve this question, let us first look at the figure, inspect it and identify the forces briefly before I draw the FBDs of the block separately. As you can see in both the blocks, there is the gravity force acting vertically downwards and the normal contact force applied by the inclined plane acting perpendicular to the inclined plane only. The string also provides the force of tension which is acting downwards down the incline on block 1 and up the incline on block 2 having the same magnitude. And since surface is rough, there is the frictional force acting on the bottom of both the blocks in the up the incline direction because the motion is down the incline. So frictional force is acting up the incline, the minus x direction in my sign convention. So these are the forces acting on the two blocks, and you must understand once again, let me tell you, that since the string is taut, the acceleration of both the blocks have to be the same. So here is my first free body diagram of block 1, that is the upper one, and let me show the forces separately. Here is the force of gravity acting vertically downwards, exerted by the earth. This is the field force. And here is the normal force acting perpendicular to the incline, applied by the incline only. Let me name the force. So this is the M1G, gravity force. And this is the normal force acting on the upper block numbered as 1. That's why I'm calling it N1, given by the incline. And as you can see, the string is applying the tension force down the incline. Therefore, this is the tension force T. And as the motion takes place down the incline, the force of kinetic friction must be acting up the incline. This force, I am calling it to be F1, but always keep in mind this frictional force is kinetic in nature because there is actual motion of the block on the inclined plane. Under these forces, the block attains an acceleration of A that is shown by this red arrow down the incline. I am calling it A only. So, I have already chosen my coordinate system. For convenience, let me show it here again by the side. The direction down the incline taken to be my plus x direction. Direction perpendicular to the incline is taken to be my plus y direction. So you can see here from the figure that the force of friction F1 acting in the minus x direction, tension force of string acting in the plus x direction, normal force N1 acting in the plus y direction. No problem with them. But the force of gravity M1G is acting neither in the x nor in the y direction. Therefore, we have to resolve this force of gravity into its x and y components. And how do we do that? Looking at the figure once again, you can see, let me show a small construction, that if I could draw a perpendicular from this bottom of block 1 onto this base of the inclined plane, I get a right angle triangle. So if this angle is theta, this angle can be shown to be 90 degree minus theta. And then, since this direction is drawn perpendicular to the inclined y direction perpendicular to it, therefore this whole angle is 90 degree. And it follows therefore that this angle is theta again, isn't it? Just see it carefully, I am using different thing to understand. I said, I draw a perpendicular on the base of incline, it becomes a right angle triangle, this angle is 90 degree. This is theta, this must be 90 minus theta, and then again, the direction of incline and the perpendicular drawn on it, the angle between them 90 degree, so this angle has to be theta. Therefore, when I go for the resolution of the force of gravity into its components, we understand in this figure, this angle is theta, and therefore, this component acting in the minus y direction is M1g cos theta. And this component acting in the plus x direction down the incline, that component is coming out to be M1g into sin theta, isn't it? With this resolution complete, let us go to write down the equations of motion of block 1. In the x direction, sigma fx, as you can see, the forces downwards, the tension force T and the component M1g sin theta, they are positive. And the frictional force F1 is acting up the incline, that is taken to be my minus x direction. So the net force in the x direction is capital T plus M1g sin theta minus F1. This net force must have provided the acceleration of A to the block 1 down the incline in the plus x direction. So by Newton's second law, this must be equal to the mass of the block M1 into its acceleration down the incline. That is my equation number 1 from the x motion of block 1. Similarly, let us proceed to write down the equation for y motion of the block, that is in the direction perpendicular to the incline plane. And you can see here, as the block moves down the incline, it has got no motion in this y direction. And this happens under two forces, N1, a force in the plus y direction, and M1g cos theta acting in the minus y direction. Therefore, equation of motion in the y direction becomes N1 minus M1g cos theta This must be equal to the mass of the block into its acceleration in the y direction, which is zero, and therefore this is coming out to be zero. This is giving me the normal force N1 acting on the block is equal to the force of gravity into cosine of the angle of inclination of the incline. That is my equation number 2. I shall come back to the equation in a short time.
Hello students, you got a glimpse of our video lessons through this small lecture. We have hundreds of lectures like this one covering various topics of advanced school level and intermediate physics in our website. They are exhaustive and often accompanied by elaborate diagrams to make concepts even clearer. They are taught with passion and sometimes with a bit of fun. So, at the end of the lesson, you have a commanding grip on the subject and you are ready for the board and competitive exams. Subscribe at physicsacademyonline.com to access video lectures of highest standard on various topics of physics.